Two Chairs No Waiting, episode number 146, Alan Newsome Interview, part 3. Welcome to Two Chairs No Waiting, brought to you each week by the fine folks over at Weaver's Department Store. Drop by over at Weaver's, pick up some wonderful Mayberry things. They got DVDs, CDs, neckties, books. If it's Mayberry, they've got it. Drop by weaversdepartmentstore.com. Two Chairs No Waiting is also brought to you by donations from listeners like you. The executive producer of Two Chairs No Waiting, episode number 146, is Floyd Lawson. And Floyd is our guest host this evening. So, Floyd, we're throwing it over to you, live from Mayberry.
Yeah. Hello. Hello there. Yeah, this is great. Floyd Lawson coming to you from Mayberry, North Carolina. Glad to be here. Glad to be here. Third episode in a row. Alan's been letting me host the show. It's great to be. Well, you know, that's because the interviews have been about him. He didn't want to have himself interview him. So he didn't do that. So he asked me to sit in and be part of the show. So I want to thank him for having me as a guest host these last 3 weeks. It's been a lot of fun for me. You know, I talk all day as a barber, but it's different. It's different here on the podcast. Yeah, but it's nice. It's good to be here. It's hard. Of course, I don't get to hear back from you very much. Yeah, so... Yeah. Anyway, thanks for coming. Thanks for being here. Two Chairs No Waiting. Yeah, and I got the magazines to swing it, too. Yeah. Anyway, this is our final episode of the interview being done with Alan Newsome. Yeah, Alan, he was interviewed by Greg Davis over at Priority Talk Radio. It's heard on WXJC, which is 92.5 FM and 850 AM in Birmingham, Alabama. Birmingham. Yeah, Birmingham. Yeah, that's really good. So they did the interview and allowed us to use it. So we appreciate that a lot. So tonight you're going to hear more discussion from Alan talking about all kinds of Mayberry things. He talks about Ernest T. and Dud Wash and Briscoe Darling. Oh, it's good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you're going to enjoy that. So let's just move on over that way. That way you can enjoy it and you'll get to hear from Alan. So let's take it away. The boys over at WXJC.
No, I wouldn't go anywhere without the old Roscoe.
Little persuader.
Blue steel baby.
All right, that's Ernest T. Bass there first, and then, of course, Barney. Classic stuff. Alan Newsome joined us here on Priority Talk. He's with us now. Frank Curry, James Cato here as well. Alan, were you out at the event, I'm going to say it was some 11 years ago, where Barney was here in Birmingham? It was at Oak Mountain Amphitheater at that time. Were you part of that night?
Right. It was the night it was really cold that night?
Yeah. It was really cold.
Yes,
it was
I was
an outdoor
there.
Event.
Yeah, Ernest T. Matter of fact, that night, Howard Morris, I got to... He was coming down through the through the audience there at the amphitheater, coming up on the stage, and I just happened. I was worried about him coming up those stairs, and I just happened to, I really felt like Lord led me out there to the stage, and Howard was coming up there, and those stairs shifted, and he reached up and grabbed my hand as I reached down to grab him, and we were good friends ever since then.
Yeah, I remember that, I remember him, doing that. Whatever you call it, what is it?
Old Aunt Mariah. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, he did that night, and then he passed away not too long after that. Maybe a couple of years.
Yeah, he passed away. I want to say it was 2006.
So it took maybe some 5 years after that or so. He passed away, and then of course Don Knotts was there that night as well, and he was on stage talking, and if I remember right, they got Betty Lynn, Thelma Lou, on the phone that night.
I believe that's right.
On the phone together.
Yeah, it was actually 2005 when he passed away. But yeah, that's Yeah, that was a great night. A lot of the cast members were there, and we've done that in other places as well. But, you know, that night was in October in Alabama, and it was unbelievably cold.
Oh, it was. I know it hurt the crowd.
Oh, it did. And
it was a nice crowd, but nothing like it could have been had the weather been nice. So it was bitter cold. I do remember that. I remember that very well. Well, now, one of the things, too, now, just coming off this Howard Morris, Ernest T. Bass situation here, old Mount Moriah, I'm trying to call both names.
Old Aunt Moriah.
All real people. He only, this surprised me when I first learned it.
How many episodes?
Yeah, he only was in, how many episodes, Alan?
Five.
Was in? Not many.
He was only in five, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, that's almost hard to believe because of the impact that he made through five episodes.
Well, the first, was it not the first episode where he wanted to get a uniform so he could persuade
No, the first one was when Dud Walsh was coming back to town from being in the Army and coming back to marry or to
Gilligan. He wanted to fight with him. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that was Dud.
No, that wasn't Gilligan. That
was the first
one.
Yeah.
Right.
Hope Cal was his name.
Looking guy. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's exactly right. But then later on, Dobie Walker, not Dobie Walker, but Gilligan, what's his name? Pyle.
Denver Pyle. I mean, not Denver.
Denver.
No, not Denver Pyle.
Like
Denver Pyle. No, Denver Pyle was, it was Bob Denver. Denver Pyle was Briscoe.
That's
he was
right,
Briscoe.
That's right. Boy, all the Pyles. Man,
yeah, that's a lot. And Bob Denver was the guy that he played Dud in that one episode.
Ernest T. had a problem with wanting to fight people. He wanted to fight Malcolm, the Englister.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, that's a great episode.
Yeah. But it's amazing he was only in five episodes.
Right. Well, Andy had said the Ernest T. character was such a strong character that had they had him on the show very often, he would have taken over the show.
Yeah.
Because it was just too strong of a character. I mean, he was the cool thing about Ernest T. We got some Ernest T. impersonators, and the cool thing about the cool thing about that character is it can do anything. I mean, because you know he's crazy, and so he can do anything he wants to, you know, at any time. So
yeah, he's a nut. He's
a nut. That's right.
Do you have a question?
Yeah, I'm always intrigued by how people end up doing what they do. Do you feel that this is a God thing that you do this impersonation?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm actually an electrical engineer. And I'm honestly kind of introverted to some extent. And so it's definitely not something I had ever planned in my entire life to be standing up in front of people, huge crowds, dressed as a barber. I really believe the Lord has given me that as a ministry to people and, you know, just a way to, you know, you go out and doing these Mayberry events and people see you and they just start smiling and they start enjoying themselves. They have a good time. They forget about all the problems they've had throughout the day. And you know, that's something special, and I really believe the Lord's given that to us. And honestly, most of the tribute artists that I work with are really all of them. They all feel the same way, that the Lord's really given them these things, these ability to go out there and just make people smile and laugh, have a good time. I mean, it's corny humor. I mean, you know, we tell really corny jokes, but that's what Barney or Floyd would tell. You know. Those kind of things. And so bringing a smile to people's face and just having an opportunity to do that. And, you know, I've been able to do the Mayberry Bible study because of this and teach it. And it's definitely a God thing, not something I would have chosen.
Yeah, I was going to ask, do you get asked to come out to churches as well and, you know, and do your thing?
I have. Yeah, I do. It's kind of just whenever they contact me. I've never really gone out pushing, trying to get events particularly, but I've done a lot of churches and things, and you know, sometimes it goes really great and you think you've really figured out how to do all this stuff, and then the next one you do, nobody laughs and you feel like Daffy Duck up on stage tap dancing and there's crickets sounding out there.
I heard Floyd the barber delivering
Sermon
on the Mount.
Give us some Floyd you know, giving some scripture or inviting someone, you know, to Christ, you know, sharing Christ with them. How would Floyd say? Floyd was a Christian. I saw him in church.
I never do it like that. I always, if I'm doing something like that, I'll do Floyd for a while, and then I'll actually be me.
Is that blasphemous to do scripture?
Yeah, I guess it could be a little bit.
I don't know. I think you should like it.
I feel like a little weird doing that sometimes, so I'll tend to drop out of character to talk to them more seriously. But definitely the character is what gets you in the door, and people enjoy themselves, and you develop a rapport with them because you're laughing, you're telling them stories, you're enjoying yourself, and so you don't actually have to preach necessarily to people to be able to touch them, I think. So, so there's a, you know, so I do end up, you know, talking, like I do the Bible study. When I do the Bible study, I don't do it as Floyd. I do it as me.
And, sure.
And it's because it's, that's just not the character particularly. I mean, not that he wouldn't talk about, I think, being a Christian. I don't think that'd be a problem with that character. There's no indication that that wouldn't be.
No, he was a good church attender.
Sure, okay. That's right.
A lot of people may not realize, too, that the character that played Floyd the Barber, his name, Howard McNear, is that right?
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There actually was another, in the early shows, another
that's
Floyd
right.
the Barber.
There was one. That's right. Walter. His name was Walter Baldwin, and he was in one episode. He was Floyd. They never said Floyd. You know, Floyd Lawson, but they did say it was Floyd, and he was at Floyd's barbershop. But he only did that one episode, and from the things I've been told, he just didn't work real well with the character, the cast. It just didn't feel right, so they ended up replacing him after that one episode with Howard McNear.
Yeah, just didn't have the right chemistry, didn't fit in. Yeah,
right. Now other things people may not know, too, that Howard McNear had a stroke.
Right.
And he was off the show for over a year, for right at a year. Right after the Convicts at Large episode, where Andy and Barney had been captured. I mean, yeah, not Andy, where Floyd and Barney had been captured up in the cabin. Right after that, Howard had a stroke, and that was in the December time frame. And so he was off the show the rest of that season, and they brought in Gomer Pyle the next year to kind of replace Floyd to some extent. And then Andy liked Howard McNear so much, he worked really hard to get Howard back into the show. Howard couldn't walk really well. He couldn't stand without assistance, really. So they actually used a kind of like a swing, like a boatswain is what it's called, I think. I'm sure I'm not saying that right. But it's a swing that was actually hooked to the back of the barber chair that he actually kind of sat in when he was acting like he's cutting hair. So you never.
I remember those. Yeah, a lot of those, you notice he'll be sitting down. They'll sit beside him and carry on the conversation. Yeah,
that's right. Or you'll see him come to the door and say, "Hey, Andy," and he say, "Hey, come on in, Floyd." And that shows Andy while you hear him walking, and then he's sitting in the chair. You know, so there's, they did a lot of things to get him on there. So you know, that was just kind of telling you how special that guy was.
Yeah, and then he passed away not long after the show ended, right?
Right. Right, and he was actually off the show before it ended because Emmett from Emmett's Fix It Shop came in and took over in that store with the Fix It Shop.
Yeah, and he did. Howard, he died in, was it like 69 or something?
Mm-hmm. That's right. Yeah,
yeah, right in there. So he never really got to live to understand the fame of how famous he became.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, for that role.
Yeah. Right. Now, and his son, I've been able to meet his son. I went out to California and went to the house. He actually still lived in his dad's house, and his name's Kit McNear. And I got to go to the house, and he showed me around and showed me all the memorabilia and stuff he had. So that was real special because he knows I impersonate his dad, and so I kind of wanted his blessing from doing that. So
yeah. Now, have you ever got to meet Andy himself?
I have been in the same room with him a few times, but I never, it's always been, it's never been a real situation where I was comfortable trying to go up and meet him, really, because I just left him alone. Yeah, because I had been invited in there by Emmett Forrest, Andy's friend, and, you know, Emmett would say, hey, you know, if it comes up and he wants to talk to you, feel free to, but, you know, he's real private, and so I didn't want to take advantage of the situation.
Sure, yeah, and he doesn't really make a whole lot of appearances anymore, does he?
No, he does not. And but he's really gracious. He was super nice that day. I mean, I wasn't interacting with him really, but just watching from the distance. But he was, you know, very pleasant. And I think people feel like that he owes them something sometimes. And I always try to tell him. I said, you know, he's brought us 50 years of fun, laughter, enjoyment just with that one show. And, you know, if he wants his privacy, I think, you know, I understand that, you know, so, but he's been very gracious to, at least he was when I was there.
Yeah, oh yeah, I'm sure. I love his gospel music too, you know, that's hard to beat his gospel music album. He does the hymns and, you know, does them kind of the old-fashioned way.
That's right.
And those are tough to beat. Well, Alan, we'll have to go here in just a minute, but now, you know, we don't know each other except for just this week and been here on the air. Now,
you know, I don't have a whole lot of hair.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw your picture. I looked. Yeah.
Okay.
Looked like Floyd had got a hold of you.
Now, yeah. Let me say this. Now, if I came into Floyd's barbershop, you saw my picture, and I come in for a haircut, what would that conversation sound like?
You know, you don't get a discount for not having much hair because I have to charge extra for having to look for hair to cut. You know, yeah.
Oh, I love it. I love it. You know what? And that is exactly right, because I'll go to barbershops and I'll say, how much just to, you know, trim me down as, you know, to just a one or whatever. And I still want $15 to do it.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh.
And now, how much were Floyd's how much were his haircuts back in the day?
Well, it changed. It was like 75 cents up to $1.50. It changed around throughout the seasons.
Yeah, now, so, you know, 50, 75 cents, something like that now.
You know, that's because Howard kept raising the rent there then, that's right.
The rent kept going up, had to go up on the prices. Well, Howard, it's been a real pleasure to have you with us, and the website is imayberry.com. Is that the main place you'd want people to know?
Sure, yeah, you can get to everything from there, so that's perfect.
Yeah, and go download the podcast. It's a great, 15, 20 minutes you do once
right.
a week.
That's right.
And it's outstanding. You can get all the back episodes. You can search through and find things that look more interesting to you. It's just a great podcast, and it's two chairs, no waiting. And this weekend, if you can, make an effort to get out to Graysville this weekend. And it's the 11th Annual Mayberry Squad Car Nationals out at the ballpark there in Graysville. There'll be the parade at 10 a.m. in the morning down Main Street in Graysville. You can stop right there at the old Eagle Market and watch it. I used to work at the Eagle Market in Graysville. So you can stop right there and watch the parade, all the squad cars come through. It's the 7th Annual Mayberry Comes to Graysville Festival. All kind of tribute artists, impersonators out there this weekend, including Alan Newsom. And Alan, we can't thank you enough for spending the last 45 minutes with us. It's been a real pleasure, real blessing.
Well, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, we hope we can have you back on again sometime. We'll for sure do it every time this year.
I would love to.
Right around the Mayberry Day. Thank
All
you
right.
so much.
All right, thank you.
Alan Newsom, and God bless you. Thank you so much. You're listening to Priority Talk here on WXJC. We've been talking Mayberry, and it's been a blast.
Hey, yeah, that was good. I hope you guys enjoyed that. It was Alan and Priority Talk Radio there from Birmingham, Alabama, WXJC. So, just thank you guys for being here. And, hey, before you go, I've got a quick story. I know we're running a little long, but, I told Alan I had to tell this story. Because, Andy had been in the barbershop the other day. He was in there, and he was telling me what Helen is telling him. He said, you know, they're at the school, a kindergarten teacher that Helen knows. Well, she was receiving gifts from her pupils there at the end of the year, you know. Yeah, well, you know, the florist handed her a gift, and she shook it and held it over her head and said, I bet I know what this is. I bet it's some flowers. And the little boy said, oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, but how did you know? She said, oh, he's just a wild guest. So the next little student there came up. It was the candy store owner's daughter. Yeah, and the teacher held a gift and shook it and said, hey, I bet I know what this is. She said, it's a box of sweets. Yeah, that's right, said the little girl. I said, that's right. How did you know that? And the teacher said, well, it's just a wild guess. Well, the next gift, well, it was from the son of a local, a local moonshiner. You know, anyway, and so the teacher held the package up, and it was leaking. It was leaking a little bit. So she touched a drop of the leakage and touched it to her tongue and said, maybe some syrup? Is this syrup? And the little boy goes, no. He's getting kind of excited. Teacher said, well, she took a little bit larger drop of the liquid there and touched it to her tongue and said, I'm not sure what that is. Is it tea? And the level goes, no. Yeah, so the teacher took one more taste of it and said, well, I give up. What is it? And the little boy, he goes, it's a puppy. Well, it's not so funny to the lady, but I thought it was pretty funny. The teacher, I'm sure, this terrible, isn't it? Well, anyway, I thought that was a good story. Eddie told it to me from Helen, so I hope you like that. But well, folks, we want to hear from you. We hear from you here back and let everybody know what you thought of the episodes here lately and the ones I've been on especially. The ones with Floyd, co-hosted. I'd like to hear from that. Yeah, so if you would, you can give us a call at 888-684-8415. Or you can email at floyd@imayberry.com. Or you can drop by our website, twochairsnowaiting.com, and leave comments on any of the episodes, and Alan will see those. And you could also go by facebook.com. You could go there as well. There's all kinds of good ways to get in touch with Alan and talk about the podcast. So we're looking forward to hearing from you, because, you know, he likes to hear from you. If you could tell him how good Floyd did. Because, maybe he'll let me be on here a little more. He hadn't had me on here a lot lately. So, and if you happen to have been watching the video podcast, there was a bunch of pictures I was showing. That was from the Taylor Home Inn. That's what Alan visited up there and was walking all around the place. And so we had pictures of that. And those pictures are also found in the show notes. So if you didn't get to see them, you can see them there. And they'll be posted there. So, folks, thanks again for watching. And we'll see you next time on Two Chairs, No Waiting, here at Mayberry Podcast. Bye, folks.